Media.
Two men say they know the exact location of the Nazi ghost train that went missing in 1945.
It's an extraordinary story.
It's captured the imagination of many who live here, even including members of the Polish government.
Na poziomie ponad 99%, że istnieje.
I'm hunting for a secret tunnel.
Whoa. It's on a big scale, isn't it?
That local legend says was hidden by the Nazis. And in it, a lost train said to be laden with gold.
And do you think this is where the rumours of this gold train comes from?
I'll consider the evidence that treasure might be hidden here. An area that for much of the war was considered the safest place in Nazi Germany.
My jesteśmy 60 metrów pod ziemią. Żadne bomby amerykańskie, angielskie, sowieckie nie były w stanie to nic zniszczyć.
I'll follow the treasure hunters who've spent years searching for the train and may now be about to find something. I'll delve into the region's past.
This feels like you're entering the dark heart of the Nazi world.
Revealing a high-level plan to build a top-secret Nazi HQ in this remote corner of the Third Reich. This extraordinary tale features a hilltop castle converted into a bolt hole for Adolf Hitler in the final months of the war.
This room now?
Yes.
Which is going to be Hitler's bedroom?
Yes, exactly.
And a mysterious network of tunnels dug out of the ground by slave labourers.
This was going to be an industrial underground city.
If Hitler was planning to retreat to this remote part of his empire, then could Nazi gold have ended up here too?
If it's true, it's the kind of thing that happens once in a lifetime. A secret underground Nazi train loaded with valuables, buried for decades. Local people who were silenced first by the Nazis, then by the Soviets, finally coming out and telling their stories. It's the kind of thing us history lovers dream about.
In the outskirts of Wałbrzych, a former mining town in southern Poland, where for many locals, treasure hunting has become an obsession. I've arranged to meet Wojciech Malinowski, a filmmaker who grew up here and who's been following the story for years.
How are you doing? Nice to meet you, Wojciech.
Nice to meet you.
Very beautiful place.
If you think it's beautiful.
I'm hoping he'll show me the tunnel that's been making headline news all over the world.
Come on, follow me.
But instead, he takes me to a nondescript piece of land, at a location known simply as Kilometer 65.
So what are we looking at here?
This area looks strange. What do you think? This part of this area.
Yeah, there's steep banks here and then there's a sort of bowl there.
And some people think that it was a little part of this railway which going to the tunnel, which probably will be there.
All the rest of those banks look like they follow the original railway line, and yet here there's this bowl.
Wojciech takes me to the K65 milestone, where the entrance to the secret tunnel is believed to be.
Ah, what's this?
Ten kamień to nie jest naturalny kamień, że tak powiem, który można znaleźć w ziemi. On też tutaj jakby nie stanowi elementu żadnej ściany, która była po tej stronie, więc prawdopodobnie jest to szczyt wjazdu do tunelu.
That is interesting. I mean, it doesn't look anything like a railway tunnel. I mean, why do you think this is the area particularly that the Germans camouflaged at the end of the war?
Znaczy, o tym wskazuje wiele rzeczy, to znaczy jego nienaturalne ukształtowanie. Jak widać, na tym terenie nie ma drzew, które są starsze niż 70 lat. To są drzewa młode, które powstają, które rosną, że tak powiem, same z siebie.
And you're right, on the other side over here
yes.
elsewhere, there are actually much older trees. Yeah.
Tak, tam są powiedzmy, drzewa oryginalne, a tutaj są te, które, że tak powiem, rosną już po tamtych latach.
About 400 meters further along the same railway embankment, Wojciech wants to show me two mysterious structures, which he thinks prove the Nazis were at work here.
So you think there's a tunnel underneath us now?
Yes, I hope.
You hope? What are these?
Od razu widać, nic tu więcej nie ma. Są tylko te dwa szyby. Jak się przyjrzeć temu dokładnie, to to jest beton i rodzaj konstrukcji, która jest charakterystyczny dla okresu III Rzeszy po prostu. I teraz pytanie jest właśnie, dlaczego coś takiego stoi w środku pola? Więc można założyć, przy założeniu, że ten tunel jest, to prawdopodobnie są dwa szyby wentylacyjne.
No way. Ventilation shafts. Of course.
Yes.
Wojciech isn't alone in his suspicions. Local treasure hunters have been scouring this area for decades. This is because in 1945, the town of Wałbrzych and the whole of Lower Silesia were not part of Poland, but Germany. It was also beyond the range of the Allied bombing campaigns that targeted the country from 1942. And so, rumor has it, many important documents, artworks, and even gold were buried in the mountains. But I'm after something more substantial than rumors. I need firmer evidence before I can even start to believe that there might be a secret Nazi railway tunnel on the outskirts of this town.
What I really want is a first-hand account. I'd love to hear from somebody who actually saw the railway, the siding, and the tunnel during the war with their own eyes. There is one man who may be able to help. His name is Tadeusz Sowiakowski. He's a retired miner, and it was him who first identified the great potential at this particular site. He spent the last two decades looking for Nazi loot.
Hi, Tadeusz. Dzień dobry. Dzień dobry.
Dzień dobry,
Tadeusz Sowiakowski is one of the last men alive to have spoken to Germans who claimed that during the war, they saw a second train track at kilometer 65.
Ah, your man cave, Tadeusz.
He first heard about the mysterious tunnel from an engine driver's assistant who regularly traveled along the railway line. And he's even built a replica of the site, as it's been described to him, in his garage.
So here we go. This is the model of the tunnel and the siding. And this is kilometer 65 here. So you've talked to an engine driver on this main line who saw two carriages here in the siding.
On przyjeżdżał tutaj właśnie i wpichał te wagony i zawsze jak jechał tym torem, bo to na dół. Ale zawsze go ciekawiło, dlaczego, bo tu była brama i tu nie było widać. I on wyszedł na ten węgiel, na ten bękiel. I zobaczył za tym płotem, że stoją dwa wagony.
Tadeusz tells me that he's spoken to other locals who confirm the train driver's account. Like him, they also claim to have seen military trains on a hidden track, running off the main line into a tunnel.
It's great to see a visualization of Tadeusz's theory. It's not all just words anymore. You can actually see it laid out. And if what he says is true, high walls would have prevented anyone using that main line from looking into these sidings here, with the exception of that one guy, that enterprising guy who stood up on the coal behind his locomotive and peered over and saw this siding. And there's the tunnel. And we have seen possibly some of the stones from that tunnel at the site. Looking at this, what really strikes me is why did the Germans go to all this trouble to make sure that this little siding and the tunnel it was connected to remained secret? There must have been something pretty important down there.
After speaking to Wojciech and Tadeusz, a picture is starting to appear. A collapsed tunnel entrance. Possible ventilation shafts emerging from the ground. Second World War accounts of a secret railway line hidden from view by the Germans. It's tantalizing, if circumstantial, evidence. But it's been enough for some locals to have gone one stage further. In 2014, local historian Andreas Richter and builder Piotr Kopper decided to scan the area with ground-penetrating radar, and they've agreed to show me what they found.
Andreas, let's see some of the surveys from this area then. Let's have a look at the tunnel and the train.
No oczywiście. Teraz jesteśmy u góry. Idziemy teraz na dół i zobaczymy, co może być pod ziemią.
What the radar technology revealed convinced them there really was something unusual at the site.
I teraz już widać, tu są równe struktury. na turach nie może być taki równo, może być no inaczej jest.
So you're saying that there's a sort of central stripe there. You're saying that's an unnatural, that's a man-made feature.
Jest równo. Po lewej i po prawej stronie jest jedna długa linia na długości 60 metrów. Popatrz, co
nawet
się
to
dzieje.
Można mówić, to wagon wykonanta.
Popatrz na to. Popatrz na ten zaczep. To jest jak kuplung, który się spina. Popatrz na to wszystko. Popatrz, jak to wygląda. Popatrz na jeszcze na jedną stronę. To jest oś. Dokładnie biegnę przez środek badania. I co jest? Popatrzcie, wszystko masz tak samo. Po lewej, jak i po prawej stronie. Jak lustrzane odbicie. Tak jak w samochodzie. Nadkole lewe, nadkole prawe.
Zobacz, jak wysoko jest skała.
To jest skała.
So that's the side of a tunnel, that's the wall of a tunnel. It's reaching up higher than what's in between it. And in between it, there appears to be a man-made symmetrical object, a big substantial object, like it's a train with an engine.
Na których coś jest załadowane. Są to jakieś pojazdy, ciała, rzeczy, które są całkowicie symetryczne. Ziemia czegoś takiego nie pokazuje nigdy. Nigdy.
The images are very seductive, but are the treasure hunters seeing what they want to believe? They don't claim the train is full of treasure, but there could be a great deal of money in this for them if they really have struck gold.
Well, you can't help but be carried away by their enthusiasm, but I did leave there slightly questioning their motivation. What was really driving them on? A great love of history and archaeology, or the desire to get their hands on that Nazi gold? They're claiming a 10% finder's fee, and they have employed a lawyer. They must believe they're onto something.
So what is it about this part of Poland that's caused so much speculation? That's what I need to find out next. For much of the war, this southeastern corner of the Third Reich was far away from the front lines. And out of range of the Allied bombing campaigns that from 1942 started to lay waste to the country's industrial heartlands. The regions that fed the German war machine. Factories were relocated here, and precious works of art were stored away for safekeeping. And beneath these mountains, they developed one of the most incredible schemes. A project so extraordinary, it defies imagination. There's a reason why the reports of a secret tunnel at kilometer 65 haven't just been dismissed out of hand and Piotr and Andreas derided as a pair of hopeful amateurs. And that is to do with its particular location. It isn't just a random railway siding in the middle of Poland. It sits right next to one of the most extraordinary and sinister Nazi projects of them all. A huge, secret, underground labyrinth of tunnels burrowed out in the final years of the war. Its code name was Risa, Giant. This top-secret project started in 1943. Hitler entrusted the work to his favourite architect, Albert Speer, and his most skilled and trusted engineers, Organisation Todt. This organisation was responsible for major construction projects. The Autobahns in the 30s. The Siegfried Line. The Reich's Western defences. And the construction of the Atlantic Wall along the western coastline of occupied Europe. But now they were tasked with something even more ambitious. I want to find out what the Risa project was about, in the hope it might shed some light on why so many people believe there's a hidden Nazi train in this area.
was a narrow bit there. It's soaking wet in here. I've heard about people entering the dark heart of the Nazi world before. This feels like you're doing it literally.
Local historian Lukács Kašek has agreed to guide me through the Risa.
We've come maybe 800 meters into the mountain here. How long are these tunnels?
Ten kompleks ma 3 kilometry. Jest największym ze wszystkich, jakie znamy w górach Sowich.
I can see there's tunnels moving off in all directions.
Tak, to jest taka kratownica. Jest trzy korytarze, które są do siebie równoległe i sześć, które przecina, co tworzy taką kratownicę, taki labirynt, można nawet powiedzieć.
So what's happened? Is this a natural cavern that they've just hit into?
Tutaj nie było nigdy naturalnych pustych. Mamy dwa korytarze, jeden dołem, drugi górą. Potem ten strop zawalano i powstawały olbrzymie hale na 12 metrów wysokości. I w większości te chodniki miały tak wyglądać.
What were they doing down here? What was the point of this complex?
Niemcy przenosili przemysł zbrojeniowy pod ziemię, więc duże prawdopodobieństwo, że tutaj te fabryki mogłyby być instalowane. My jesteśmy 60 metrów pod ziemią. Żadne bomby amerykańskie, angielskie, sowieckie nie były w stanie tu nic zniszczyć.
And so you think this was going to be a huge, almost an industrial underground city?
No, można tak powiedzieć, że gdyby Niemcy skończyli, połączyli ze sobą kompleksy, mogło być to potężne podziemne nazistowskie miasto.
Lukács tells me that many Risa tunnels have yet to be discovered, while other explorers have claimed that the Nazis hid treasure and top secret weapons here in the last days of the war. All this seems to strengthen the case for the possible existence of another secret tunnel at nearby K-65. The Nazis did complete other projects like this, like the vast underground factories discovered in central Germany after the war, where military aircraft and advanced rockets like the V-2 were being manufactured. But if the Risa project had been finished, it would have been even bigger. Could Hitler have been planning to develop even more deadly weapons down here?
Not surprisingly, how much moisture was coming into the tunnels back there. Some sections of the tunnel have completely flooded. And you have to get along hauling yourself on a rope. It's just otherworldly. Totally silent.
Whatever the Risa tunnels were intended for, there is no doubting their impressive scale.
This is the biggest space I've seen down here by far. It's probably three stories high. 100 meters long at least. It's vast. It's like an underground cathedral. It's not surprising that the people who came after, the Poles who arrived in this area, when confronted with these ghostly, echoing, half-built monuments, made up stories, made up legends. These caverns have bred a whole generation of conspiracy theories.
Some say the Risa complex was even designed to house the German atom bomb the Nazis were developing. But whatever its purpose, one thing that's certain is that these tunnels came at an incredible human cost. It's estimated that 5,000 people subjected to forced labor died on the project, hacking out granite rock in temperatures just above freezing. For the thousands of innocent people worked to death here, Project Risa was simply a giant tomb. I'm going to Gross Rosen concentration camp. It would have supplied the slave laborers for the excavation work carried out underground. Over the entrance is the great Nazi lie: work sets you free. Emaciated prisoners like these carried out the back-breaking work. Local expert Marta Sadwoka has studied the living hell that was Camp Gross Rosen.
Most of the military industry was focused in the hands of forced laborers or prisoners of concentration camps. And in case of camps like this, the work was a means to kill them all. So extermination was, of course, fulfilled in here.
Of all the Nazi labor camps, the ones at Riesa had the harshest living conditions and some of the highest mortality rates.
The average lifespan was 2 or 3 months for one person. And this is how long they actually could live, especially when they worked physically as here.
So was Riesa seen as a particularly brutal way to finish prisoners off? That's why they sent the Jewish prisoners there.
Definitely. People had to work underground. And even when the walls were exploded in some parts, they were sometimes not released to the surface. So they still had to work in the dust and various different toxic fumes out of the explosive substances. They were ending even quicker than here.
With death tolls rising and the Soviets advancing, what must have been going through the minds of the men in charge here?
Well, the last couple of days at the Riesa and the Gross Rosen camp have just driven home the sheer insanity of what the Nazis were doing in this region. I mean, the inhumanity and barbarism of that camp, but also underline that, the stupidity of murdering your own workforce when allegedly they were working on this enormously important, grandiose project, which actually just seems to me to be a totally insane folly. Its purpose still to this day a mystery.
I want to find out what else was going on in this region that might help to explain why a Nazi gold train could have ended up here too. This is Schorsch Castle, the largest and most stunning palace in the whole of Lower Silesia. The site of the suspected tunnel is less than 2 miles away. I've come here as I've heard that there is a link between the castle, the Riesa tunnels, and the mystery at K65, and that Hitler himself may lie at the heart of the connection.
Hi there.
Welcome at Schorsch Castle.
Thank you. It's more like a palace than a castle.
It is a palace and a castle.
Mateusz Mikitisian has studied the history of the castle.
Since 1509 until 1933, it belongs to Counts of Hochbergs.
Mateusz tells me how the Nazis confiscated the castle from its owners and planned to make it the center of their operations in this area.
Let me show you this interesting room that is under the black courtyard.
This is a very different feel, isn't it?
Oh, this is actual Nazi work. This is the guard room, the room that they were preparing for protecting important people that were staying here in the castle. And it was actually an escape room for elevators, for shafts that they are here.
So shafts leading where?
Leading under the ground, into the tunnels.
So there's a whole network of tunnel under the castle?
At least 2 levels. Some people say more. We know right now for sure that there are at least 2 levels of over 1,400 square meters underground tunnel covered with concrete in 75%.
So that's why this place is talked about as part of the Riesa complex, because the tunnel's here as well.
Exactly. Let me show you the shaft that is still here. And that was one of the evacuation elevators.
Wow.
So you could escape very easily to the undergrounds.
I've been to the rest of the Riesa. It was for factories and for underground armaments. Why incorporate this palace?
We believe it's supposed to be a headquarter for very important people from German Reich.
So who was supposed to come here?
very important person. I think the most important in German Reich that time, Adolf Hitler.
Mateusz tells me that work to convert the castle began in mid-1944. The plan was to make it suitable for the Nazi high command. At the same time, as many thousands of German soldiers were losing their lives on the Eastern Front, no expense was spared as the Nazis redecorated the castle. The beautiful green and red rooms were painted white, its Baroque and Rococo features ripped out and replaced with the Nazis' favorite neoclassical style, making room for the greatest works of art looted from across Europe.
So it's amazing how much the Nazis managed to reshape this. They only had a year. It must have been a huge effort they put in.
Not even a year. 10 months, and 25 young architects were working here on preparing this Lower Silesian splendid residence, known as the Pearl of Silesia, to the grandest residence of Adolf Hitler. And that was the room that was prepared for him as his bedroom.
This room now?
Yes.
Which is going to be Hitler's bedroom?
Yes, exactly. And that's why these two doors were created, two pearl doors, to lead to his bathroom, but not only bedroom, but also his private lift, leading to the tunnels under the ground.
So he had just outside the doors of his bedroom, he had a lift. So if there was an air raid or something, he could just get straight in and go down to the tunnels. The Risa mystery just grows larger and larger every time I learn more about it.
And there is so many more mysteries to actually uncover here.
Clearly, what Hitler had in mind here was a new command center.
By the time the Nazis took over this castle, the war in the East was going badly and the Soviet Red Army was advancing. Now, Hitler seems to have responded to that by doubling down on the war effort, prepare himself and his empire for a war of annihilation against the Soviet Union. He had the vast Risa complex constructed in this area, kilometers of tunnels perhaps designed to be top secret weapons production facilities. The new Führer HQ was to be linked to the Risa complex, creating a subterranean shelter for 27,000 top Nazi and SS personnel spread across 25 kilometers. The resources this project consumed were a massive drain on the war effort, something the Nazis could ill afford at this time.
Albert Speer, who was Hitler's chief architect and weapons production minister, said that what was going on in this region sucked in more concrete, more materials, than the construction of every single air raid shelter right across the Third Reich. So this was a huge focus for Hitler himself. And a big clue to that still lies beneath my feet.
My guide to the tunnels under the palace is Leopold Stembowski.
How are you doing?
Who has lived in the castle grounds all his life. He tells me that work here was far more sophisticated than at the Risa, only a few miles away.
Yeah, that's completely different, isn't it? Two stories high, mm-hmm. Concrete lined. Whoa. It's on a big scale, isn't it? It's a lot further advanced than the other tunnels I've seen. This must have been a priority for them.
Są wielkie te tunele, rzeczywiście robią ogromne wrażenie, że kubatura ich jest duża, tu można swobodnie poruszać się było samochodem i prawdopodobnie tak mieli też poruszać się przyszli właściciele czy użytkownicy tego zamku.
I can now see what all the concrete was used for. Leopold then showed me a peculiar section of wall. It could indicate that something incredibly big was being hidden here.
Stoimy przed ścianą, no, która jest pod każdym względem tajemnicza. Jak widzimy ściany pozostałe, to one są bardziej starannie zrobione. Ta nie. Ta ściana jest odlana niestarannie. co raczej nie jest podobne do niemieckiej roboty. Prawda? Tu właśnie świadkowie stwierdzili, że na przedłużeniu tego tunelu istnieje duża przestrzeń niewykończona, wykuta w skalę.
Could these accounts of a large space behind this wall indicate the existence of a secret railway line out of the castle?
So what's interesting is we're very close here to the site where those people claim to have found a tunnel with perhaps a train in it. Surely that's related to this big facility here because we're so close.
Istnieje taka teoria, że ten tunel z tym złotym pociągiem miał mieć powiązanie, czy miał prowadzić do zamku książ. Jeżeli by miał prowadzić, to na pewno nie od strony zachodniej, czy północnej, czy południowej, tylko od strony wschodniej. To jest ta strona, prawda? Nie negujemy takiej hipotezy, że pod naszymi podziemiami znajduje się stacja kolejowa.
Were there plans for a rail connection from these tunnels to the main line at K65? It's possible because we know that Hitler traveled everywhere on military trains and that most of his HQs had hidden railway access. It makes me wonder if this is what they were planning at the castle.
While I was at the castle, they did tell me that there used to be a narrow gauge railway, a little service railway that came off the main line just here and possibly followed the line of this raised embankment here. What's fascinating, what's tantalizing, that we're now only 400 or 500 meters away from where the finders think they've identified that tunnel with the collapsed entrance. Could it have been that the plan was to expand this railway and allow a full-scale train to go up to the castle, deliver the Führer to his headquarters? In which case, that tunnel back down there, it could have been a facility in which to house the Führer's train, keep it away from prying eyes. And that's why, because of the sensitivity around it being designed for Adolf Hitler himself, it was disguised in 1945. It's possible.
If they do find a tunnel at K65, the fact that Hitler himself could be connected to it gives this investigation a whole new level of importance. This could be a historical gold mine, whether there's treasure there or not. Back at K65, the Polish authorities are taking the claim that a tunnel exists seriously. But they're worried the Nazis may have booby-trapped the area. So before any dig can start, the army is sent in. This is just the latest in a series of hold-ups to hit the treasure hunters. In 2015, Piotr and Andreas's hopes suffered a dramatic setback. With so much speculation about the train, other experts got in on the act, carrying out their own surveys of the site. And at one packed press conference, with the world watching, the show was stolen by another team of experts, led by geophysicist Professor Madej. His announcement was a showstopper.
Proszę Państwa, tunel może jest, ale pociągu
nie ma. I'm going to see the man who may have just killed our story. I'm interested to know why two sets of people could have such wildly different results. Professor Madej works at the renowned AGH University of Science and Technology in Krakow, the world's oldest geophysics department.
Magnetycznego pola.
His assistant is going to give me a demonstration of the magnetometer equipment they used at K65.
Magnetyczna była.
Is it heavy?
No, no heavy.
Yes, yes, very heavy.
And you had to carry it all around that railway site.
Can I?
Here we go, yeah.
Thank you.
That is heavy, wow. And he makes you do this.
Mnie nie zmusza, ja to po prostu lubię.
Okay, it's good for you, it's good.
Yes.
Okay.
So can I see how fast you are? Let's go into the corridor, let me see how fast you walk over the site. Come on.
Okay. Mogę?
Okay, yeah, okay, go for it. Oh, so you can go quite fast if you're looking for a big object. Sounds like it's going crazy.
Dźwięk zależy od tego, co jest wokół mojej sondy. Tu jest bardzo dużo stali, w związku z tym wysoko piszczy. Gdyby tej stali było mało, te dźwięki byłyby mniejsze. To znaczy, że ktoś koło mnie idzie z kamerą.
And so when you were...
Umieszczone są rury.
Nie, to kamera.
Yeah.
Kamera.
Tak.
So is this the exact equipment you used to demonstrate there is no train down there?
No train. Być może jest tunel, ale pociągu nie ma.
Tunelu Perhaps też nie ma.
You're breaking hearts, saying there's no train.
Na 65. kilometrze pociągu nie ma. Tunelu też nie ma.
Professor Madej proceeded to give me the science behind his conclusion. He told me they had found some anomalies at the site, but these were quickly discounted.
Znajduje się jeden z tych elementów, to była rura stalowa na głębokości jednego metra. To było w granicach, jednostkach stosowanych w badaniach magnetycznych, w granicach 100-200 nanotesli. Natomiast ten pociąg na tej głębokości, jeżeli założyć, że tory kolejowe będą przebiegały na tej samej wysokości, co obecne, to wykonane badania powinny wykazać anomalie rzędu prawie 4000 nanotesli. Takich anomalii nie stwierdziliśmy.
So, could the only gold train be this one on Professor Madej's desk? And what the world is getting excited about? Be just a pipe lying a meter below the ground. Professor Madej's results seem damning, so I've decided to revisit the treasure hunters.
No, ja nie ukrywam, dla mnie była szokiem, bo byłem przekonany, że mając taki świetny sprzęt i dysponując takim doświadczeniem i taką bazą danych, nie będzie to jakiś duży problem, żeby to odkryć. No, jednak okazał się problemem. No, dla mnie to był szok.
But did it make, has it made your job more difficult because the scientist said there's nothing there? Is it now harder to get the excavation going?
Tak. Mieliśmy na nasze prace tam sponsorów, inwestorów, co chciał pomóc dać. No pieniądze po prostu. Ale jak AGH mówi, tam nic nie ma, no to wszyscy sponsorzy uciekali. I teraz no po prostu idziemy dalej i będziemy wszystko sam finansować.
Andreas and Piotr are not giving up and are still planning to go ahead with their dig. In fact, they're so convinced they're right, they're investing their own money to prove it. While they sort out the finance and permissions for the dig, I want to look into how Nazi gold could have got here. The evidence I've gathered so far, a possible secret railway line linking the castle to K65, the spot where the treasure hunters want to dig, plans for a new headquarters for Hitler, a network of underground tunnels, perhaps to house Hitler's weapons factories. The idea that Nazi treasures could have been sent here for safekeeping is at the very least plausible. But where did it come from? The answer could lie in the location itself. K65 marks the distance to the regional capital, Wrocław. When Hitler came to power, it was called Breslau. And during the war, the city was a safe haven for valuable national treasures, as well as stolen Nazi loot. It was also the transit point for much of the gold and jewelry taken from Jews killed in the death camps. But by early 1945, the Soviet Red Army was at the gates. As the city prepared for a last stand, The Nazis desperately tried to move their valuables to safety. I'm meeting Professor Tomasz Glawiński, an expert on Breslau's wartime fate. He tells me what evidence there is for treasures leaving before the Soviets encircled and sealed the city.
Bo to, że ewakuowano z miasta i że gromadzono na przykład dzieła sztuki, archiwalia, ważne dokumenty, to wiemy na pewno. Mamy tego dowody, dowody pisemne.
And do you think this is where the rumors of this gold train comes from? This evacuation of valuables from the city?
No z całą pewnością ludność w mieście widziała, że wyjeżdżają z miasta konwoje. Tą ewakuację dzieł sztuki i innych wartościowych rzeczy, którą szacuje się, że przeprowadzono przy pomocy około 100 transportów. Być może wtedy narodziła się legenda, że coś jest w tajemnicy, po cichu, po nocy wywożone, że ktoś widział skrzynię, ktoś widział zasunięte plandeki ciężarówek i być może tam jest coś, co wywozi się bardzo wartościowego.
As the Soviets closed in, Breslau descended into chaos as people tried to flee by any means possible. The main station was crowded with civilians desperately seeking a way out of the city. So, could a train with a cargo full of gold left Breslau at this point, slipping out amidst the confusion and panic? It is possible to believe that this city was in such a state of chaos and uproar that a shipment of gold could have made it here in trucks, unobtrusively transferred onto a train and taken out of town. It would have been a crazy time, these platforms thronged with refugees trying to escape the clutches of the Russians. And it strikes me that a small shipment, it could have slipped out of the city. People weren't taking notes in triplicate and filing them. It is possible. Back at K-65, Andreas and Piotr have finally been given permission by the authorities to clear the area in preparation for their dig. Crowds have started to gather to get a sneak peek, but our treasure hunters have decided to fence the dig off from the public in order to keep anything they find private. While we wait for the dig to begin, I've been looking for evidence that gold was hidden in the hills and mountains around K-65, and I think I've found it.
Przedstawiamy reportaż będący rezultatem wieloletnich poszukiwań zarówno.
It's fantastic. Classic. Golden age Polish television from the 1970s. Might not look like much to the modern eye, but this is actually a vital clue into whether any German gold could have got out of Breslau before the Soviets arrived. In the interview, a member of the Polish security service claimed the Nazis had hidden large quantities of gold in nearby mountains. The man at the root of this mystery is Herbert Kloser. Kloser claimed to have been a vet in the Wehrmacht, though Polish intelligence in fact believed he'd been an SS officer. Kloser's being a little bit evasive, but he does admit to taking part in an operation where 50 chests of gold were taken out of Breslau, and he even says where he took them.
To jest wielka tajemnica i mnie nie mieli prawo tam o się dużo dopytać i tak dalej, o masz się jechać, zabierz się prowiant i będziesz się kilka dni zajęty.
I jaką panowie drogą jechaliście gdzie?
Drogą jechaliśmy z Wrocławia, no prosto tam, do Jeleniej Góry. Z Wrocławia do Jeleniej Góry.
The film followed the route that Kloser claims to have taken, and I've decided to retrace it too, up into the mountains. Jelenia Góra is in the same mountain range as Valbj, and only 50 kilometers from K-65. According to Closer, they brought the treasure on the back of trucks up here to the slopes of Mount Śnieżka, which is on the modern Polish-Czech border. And up here, high in the mountains, they transferred that treasure from the trucks to horseback. Now, they went up the hill on the horses with the treasure. And at that point, he tells interrogators that he fell off his horse and got an injury. Well, slightly convenient, you might think. He goes back down, he goes to hospital, and he's not there when the treasure is deposited for safekeeping somewhere in these hills. One of his comrades comes back down, visits him in hospital, and tells him that the mission was completed. The treasure was stowed. But he, of course, claims he doesn't know where it is. It does mean that I could be just meters away from Nazi gold now. Well, I've got to get out of Silesia. I've got gold fever like everyone else in this place. I'm going crazy. But it is tantalizing. The Closer story is evidence that the Nazis were hiding secret cargoes of gold in the mountains not far from Valbzich. So, if there is any secret tunnel at K65, one of those cargoes could have ended up there. The diggers are moving in, and after a year of growing anticipation, the excavation has finally begun. Andreas and Piotr have assembled a team of 64 people, many local volunteers, and they're confident of uncovering a secret Nazi tunnel and train. So far on this journey, I've been down tunnels, I've visited castles, I've seen the appalling human cost of the mad Nazi building plans. I've followed the journey of Nazi gold. And now I'm back here at kilometre 65. Behind me, the dig is just beginning. And we are finally going to find out whether those treasure seekers have got exactly the right place, as they believe, and whether there's gold down there. Piotr and Andreas have opened up several trenches along the top of the embankment, where their surveys indicate the tunnel is located. They've also been doing new scans of the area, which they say back up their original findings.
Były dodatkowe jeszcze inny sprzęt ukraiński, tak jak mala, i to pokazuje na jeden miejsce.
Trochę tunelu.
The new scans have instilled confidence in the team that they will definitely find something. Everything in this investigation suggests that it is just possible that gold could be hidden somewhere in these mountains. But is it at kilometre 65? Before I find out if Andreas and Piotr are right, there's one last story that I want to explore. When I first came here, 85-year-old miner Tadeusz Slawakowski told me that the Nazi security around K65 was very tight, and that some local residents living near the tunnel entrance were killed as the Soviets approached Valbzich on the last day of the war.
So are you saying that the Nazis murdered the people who lived in these houses?
Więc tutaj 5 maja te domy tu stały, tutaj stały. Ale teraz znaleźliśmy w dokumentach, że tu był do tego domu rzucony granat. Od granatu te ludzie zginęli. Nie? I teraz jest zagadka. Czy z tego okna było widać tu stąd to zamaskowane? Nie wyjaśniona sprawa.
Tadeusz thinks these murders are evidence that the Nazis wanted to keep their activities at K65 secret. A secret so significant that uncovering it could cost you your life. This intrigues me. Because while I've uncovered some evidence that a gold train might be buried around here somewhere, this could help pinpoint it to the exact place where the treasure hunters are digging. I've decided to try and check it out. Frustratingly, the original house has since been demolished. But incredibly, given all the death and mayhem of the last stages of the war, the murder of these three people was actually recorded in a local church register.
It's the first time I've actually been able to sit down with some real evidence in black and white, written down at the time of these events that I'm trying to unravel. It's evidence that three women were murdered in exactly the place that we're fascinated by, meters away from this secret railway siding. But tragically, frustratingly, it doesn't tell us who did it. And it puts the date at exactly the time when it could have been either side. The German army were in the process of collapsing. This was the last day of the Third Reich. And the Soviet army were on the fringes of town about to push in and take over. It's an absolute turning point in world history. And these three women were killed at that time. The fact is, this doesn't get us any closer to being definitive about whether there's a tunnel under that hill and whether it was deliberately disguised. Back at the dig, and like me, Piotr and Andreas have hit a dead end. What they thought was the top of the tunnel is in fact a glacial deposit. Intricate rock formations dating back millions of years. And the train they thought they'd seen on their scan hasn't yet materialized. I get the sense they're not feeling quite as confident as they once were.
Where did your scan show that the train was?
Właśnie tutaj, w tym miejscu. Obok tej dziury jakiejś. Tutaj jest właśnie ten teren, gdzie mamy najpiękniejszy, najładniejszy obraz z georadaru. Jeszcze nie udało się nam go ruszyć ze względu na tą skałę.
So you're saying there is still a tunnel here, we just haven't found it yet?
Nie, no jesteśmy za wysoko. W tym miejscu jesteśmy za wysoko. Potrzebujemy przynajmniej jeszcze 10-12 metrów zejść niżej. Nie możemy się przez nią przebić, będziemy musieli użyć wiertnicy.
Piotr and Andreas are saying that to dig deeper, they need heavy drilling equipment. And they require extra permissions from the authorities before continuing. For now, the treasure hunters have no choice but to fill the hole in.
Well, the dig has officially finished, and we can now say for certain that the hunt for the Nazi gold train has produced no Nazis, no gold, and no trains. I've got to admit, I'm a little bit gutted. I tried to remain skeptical throughout, but a little part of me wanted to believe, a little part of me hoped that there would be a gold train down here and that I would be privileged enough to witness one of the most remarkable moments of archaeological discovery of all time. But instead, there's nothing.
Na pewno nie jest koniec świata. I na pewno, jak ten pociąg jeszcze nie jest, to on stoi dalej. I będziemy znowu myśleć, jak to najlepiej robić. I robimy jeszcze jednak.
It's frustrating that no gold train has yet been found. But I think I've uncovered an even more compelling story. Could the secret Riesa tunnel complex and the remodeled castle reveal one of Hitler's final and most ambitious plans? Was he hoping to retreat here, relocating his weapons factories to the tunnels below, and then fighting on from this final defensive redoubt? If this was his plan, then perhaps it makes it more likely that there is a gold train hidden somewhere in these hills. And maybe it's just a matter of time till someone finds it. As I was preparing to leave, I got a surprise call from Wojtek, the local filmmaker I first met when I arrived, asking me to meet him half a kilometre away from the dig. He was the man who first persuaded me there could be something to this legend. He still thinks our treasure hunters are onto something, but they're not digging in quite the right place. You see, I came onto this piece of land with you and you convinced me the train was here. I was so excited because of these, what might be ventilation shafts or hatch covers or something. Why aren't they digging here?
Znaczy, ja mam od samego początku podejrzenia, że tutaj, po tej stronie wiaduktu znajdują się o wiele ciekawsze artefakty niż po tamtej stronie. Moim zdaniem prace powinny się zacząć z tej strony, dlatego że chociażby te szyby świadczą o tym, że coś pod tą ziemią było. Generalnie wydaje mi się, że cała historia się nie zakończyła jeszcze. Znaczy, ona prawdopodobnie nigdy się nie zakończy.